this is my process for Home to Roost. I did some little comp sketches, a few inches wide, and when I was satisfied with one, I took pictures of some really wonderful friends who were willing to model for me. Then I did a full rendered sketch, and next a color study in oil on board. Then I went to grid the picture. I like to use iPhoto, and I just take a picture of my drawing, and then I press straighten in the iPhoto edit section, and it puts a grid on the drawing for you. And that's a little shortcut that I like to do. And then I slowly drew the picture on. I sped it up about 200% so you wouldn't be too bored. My friend wasn't actually wearing a chicken costume. I looked into it, but I couldn't find the perfect costume. So he just wore shorts and a t-shirt, and he was holding two bicycle helmets put together for the shape of the mask that I wanted. You can see some of the reference photos that I'm using for inspiration, and then some of the photos that I took of my friends on my wall, which I just taped up there. My inspiration is from the golden age of Hollywood, in particular, The Honeymooners, just that classic American comedy, a little bit outrageous at times. My dad used to make us watch The Honeymooners all the time, so that visually represents a newlywed's first apartment. What I did for the wooden door was I just mixed up some raw umber with some different colors in it and used a palette knife, just scraped it right on the canvas, and it kind of left some interesting wood-looking patterns. And that went pretty quickly, and I was really pleased with it. I'd never done that before. I'll chime in later with some more details about how I painted it.
One night, Farmer Brown was taking the air, locked up the barnyard with the greatest of care. Down in the hen house, something stirred when he shouted, "Who's there?" This is what he heard. "There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So calm yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. We chickens trying to sleep, and you butt in and hobble, 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 hobble with your chin. There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. You're stomping around and shaking the ground. You're kicking up an awful dust."
As you can see, I just put on some local color just for reference points of where I wanted the painting to go. And then a few days later, I'm back here filming. I couldn't figure out how to load the video onto the computer for a few days, so sorry about that. This is my first video, but they will get better, I promise.
Nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So quiet yourself.
I painted and repainted this tablecloth about four times. I had a checkered tablecloth like this, and I put it over my round table, but I just couldn't get it to fold the way that I wanted it to. So in the end, I had to make up the folds and then make up the pattern on them. And that was the most challenging part of this painting. The thing is, I love working from life, and if I can use reference from life, I always will. But life, most of the time, doesn't do exactly what I want it to in painting and in reality. So I have to make up parts.
One night, Farmer Brown was taking the air, locked up the barnyard with the greatest of care. Down in the hen house, something stirred when he shouted, "Who's there?" This is what he heard. "There ain't nobody here but us chickens."
I love this little potholder. This I didn't have to make up, and I was so pleased.
And can stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. We chickens trying to sleep, and you butt in and hobble, 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 hobble with your chin. There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. You're stomping around and shaking the ground. You're kicking up an awful dust. We chickens trying to sleep, and you butt in and hobble, 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 hobble. It's a sin. Tomorrow is a busy day. We got things to do. We got eggs to lay. We got ground to dig and worms to scratch. It takes a lot of setting, getting chicks to hatch. Oh, there ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So quiet yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. Kindly point that gun the other way.
I'm so happy with the way that the mask turned out. My model for the mask was actually a lemon, so I could get the right colors. The whole idea of Chicken Man started when I was at a bar with my friends, and I really wanted to use them in a painting. The guy said sarcastically that he wouldn't model for me unless he was wearing a chicken suit. And I thought that was the best idea ever. I obsessed about it for about 3, maybe 4 years, and tried to convince myself not to paint it for one reason or another. Thought, oh, no one will ever take me seriously again if I do a chicken series. But I just had to. I love the idea of Chicken Man, and I almost see him as a heroic figure. Not like a chicken, you know, but this superhero that goes off to work and really doesn't like his or her job, but does it for the family, and sometimes jobs feel like you might as well be wearing a chicken suit.
The other way, and hobble, hobble, hobble off, and hit to the hey, boss man, what do you say?
Here's the final image. You can see detailed shots of the image on my website, and I'll be posting more videos weekly. I promise they'll get better.